I'm trying to give back to the community that I helped destroy.
I feel like a giant because, you know, I'm in a position that a lot of people would love to be in.
I have the opportunity to go to work every morning knowing that I have family members that don't have that, that have gotten laid off.
All the solar companies around the Bay Area should certainly take a look at this program.
Short-term training leading to livable wages for area residents and residents that typically would not have access to careers in the construction or clean energy industries.
These are the things that they need, the skills, the training to go forward.
Why isn't this happening everywhere?
Literally out of two meetings, the program was born. And it was put in place to create opportunities, to reduce violence. And by doing so, we have put in place what I consider is really a world-class training program that not only provides quality training for the individual, but also positively impacts that individual, their family, and their community.
So this is part of a brownfields job training initiative that EPA has been running since the mid-1990s. It's really been one of those unsung heroes of EPA.
The first day of class, I was a little skeptical, didn't really know what to expect. But after I got to meet all the students, my dad calls me up every night, "You're a Boilermaker, you weld, that's so cool."
Just being able to support myself, actually, wow. And start off in Richmondville, wow, I can't really find words to express how I feel about that.
My mother is proud of me. You know, she loves that I'm working and not in the streets. You know, something that I could be doing, but I choose not to.
They're coming from various backgrounds, disadvantaged at times, former incarcerated individuals, young mothers with children that have no extra support, have found a new opportunity in life, and that's exciting.
Seeing people who've never worked before and whose parents have never worked be the incredible example for their families.
I'm in the 320-fold labor union, and you know, things is looking all right. You know, like I said, my mom's feeling proud about my stuff, man. Family looking a little bit better up to me, man.
Instead of being out there constantly looking over your shoulder, you know, here you don't. Here it gives you a path to run on. You know, you can create your own avenue from here forward or continue to follow others. You know, but it gives you a place for you to stand.
Carpenters have been involved with Richmondville since the beginning. I've seen this program change young people's lives. When they graduate from this program, they will get a job that will lead to a career in construction that pays very good wages and benefits.
So these young people in Richmondville are getting a chance to get in on the ground floor for a career that's just going to continue to soar as America changes its energy policy for the future.
Clean energy jobs, that's the future, and you're getting ready for the future now. And that is so important.
I measure the success of Richmondville when employers come back and they want to hire another solar installer, or they want another carpenter's apprentice or laborer's apprentice. That is a good sign of success for our program.
We're really thrilled to have Richmondville graduates coming here. This is a program that's been long needed, and we're just happy to be able to offer jobs to these graduates. They're very, very dedicated, and this is an absolutely ideal opportunity to bring people in who really want to be in this industry, who've got some training, and who are going to be good long-time employees.
As you look at our Wall of Fame, you'll see scores of graduates that have been successful in the program and now are working in the industry, making a good living, making livable wages, and we want to be able to continue to grow the number of individuals that have access to this training program to meet industry demand.
And to create a clean energy future is one of our, you know, largest goals. I would like to extend warm congratulations to you for your accomplishment and for being here. And I hope we'll work with you closely as you get jobs out there installing clean energy technology.
Very few people are doing it, so I really want to congratulate the mayor and the whole city family, Sal and others, for moving beyond the rhetoric and saying, this is the third one. You know they're doing it right when you're on number three.
So I'm very excited to be able to go back and report to the Vice President that we in fact have a community that has achieved what has been so difficult for so many other communities to do. You all have done it, whereas so many others have failed. It's really quite a tribute to you.
Why aren't there 250 folks sitting to my left and right and in front of you? Where are the other cities and counties all across the state, for that matter, around the country?
And it's presented today to Richmond Build in recognition of significant contributions to protecting California's environment and, of course, significant contributions to the young people who rely on us. So here, this is for you, and thank you, Sal.
I can change the world with my own two hands, make a better place with my own two hands, make a kinder place. Oh, with my own two hands, with my own two hands. Oh,